Srinivas Lakyam. Today we are going to see how to install Tomcat on CentOS 7 or RHEL 7. Okay, so the installation is same in RHEL flavors. Okay, so first we will see how to download Apache Tomcat 9. So this is the latest version. Next we will see how to start Tomcat, and we'll see how to stop Tomcat. Next we'll see how to access Tomcat in browser. We will see how to access Tomcat in web browser. Okay, we will see how to access Tomcat in web browser. Next we will see how to create users. Okay, next finally we will see how to deploy var file. Okay, we will see all these steps. So let's start first downloading Apache and installing Apache. Download and install. Okay, so first I want to download this version. So let's see how to download. Let's open any web browser. So I have already installed CentOS. Okay, I'm opening web browser. So let's open web browser and search Google. Okay, open Google. Yes, search Apache Tomcat download. So you will see first page, Apache Tomcat 9.0. Let's click on this one. Click this first link. Here you will see apache-tomcat-9.0.0.m26-deployer.tar.gz. Next we need, so there are some other Windows supported zip file, and this one is Tomcat, our supported Linux supported Tomcat. This is supported by all Linux operating systems. You can click on this one. You can click this one. It will start download, or right click on this link, copy link location, just go to where you want to download. So I want to download in OPT directory. Let's go to OPT directory. Use wget and paste that link. So before that, let's see whether Tomcat directory is presented or not. There is no Tomcat installation, right? So wget, paste that link, and let's run. It started downloading. It's verifying link. So started downloading. It's downloaded. Let's check ls. So Apache Tomcat is downloaded. Once it is downloaded, so what we did, so to download we use wget, this link, right? Okay, next install. So to install, just extract tar file. So this is tar with gz file, right? Tar with gz file, right? Gz file. So to extract tar with gz file, we use command called tar-xvzf. xzvf. You can use options anywhere, any type. Then this tar file name. Here x stands for extract tar file. This is gz file, right? That's why I used option z. V means verbose. It displays extraction process. F means file. Okay, let's execute this one. Press enter. So it is extracted. ls. So you will see extracted tar file. This tar file is not required. So remove this one. rm-rf. So gz. Next, if you want to use same name, use this name. But if most of the times we rename this one. So I am renaming this one with Tomcat 9. So to rename, I am using mv Apache Tomcat M26. I am giving name is Tomcat 9. Now ls, you will see Tomcat 9 folder. Okay, so extraction is simple, installation is simple. Just extract the tar file, that's it. So installation is very easy. Tomcat installation is very easy. Next, once installation is completed, we start, we stop Tomcat. To start, to stop Tomcat, Tomcat home directory contain. So Tomcat, this is Tomcat home directory, right? Where it is located? Under root, under opt, right? So under opt, we have Tomcat 9. Under Tomcat 9, you will see bin directory, and you will see config directory and web apps directory. So these are very important directories. Under bin under bin you will see two cell script. There are multiple cell script. In that two cell script, one is startup dot sh, and another one is shutdown dot sh. So by using startup dot sh, we can start Tomcat. By using shutdown.th, we can stop Tomcat. Okay, by default Tomcat starts on port 8080. Okay, let's see this process. So let's go to Tomcat 9. ls, here you will see bin directory, conf directory, web apps directory. These are very very important directory. Let's go to bin, cd bin. Here you will see multiple scripts. In this startup.sh, are you seeing startup.sh? This is for to start Tomcat. Shutdown.sh to stop Tomcat. Okay. How do we start this Tomcat? /startup.sh. Press enter. So Tomcat is started. Okay. Once Tomcat is started, how to access Tomcat in web browser? So we use open web browser. Okay, then type http://localhost or IP address or hostname :8080. It opens Tomcat home page. It opens Tomcat home page. Okay, let's see. So I have already opened web browser, right? I'm opening new link, new tab. So localhost 808080. So this is Tomcat home page. In this Tomcat home page, click on manager app. So here it will ask username and password. So did we create any users for this Tomcat? No, right? So if you not create, default it comes with one password called Tomcat, username called Tomcat, and password, no password. Click on OK. So let's try one more time. Tomcat. So there is no user Tomcat. So how do we create users? So to create users, there is one directory called conf directory. Under conf directory, there is a file called tomcat-users.xml file. In this file, we configure username and password. Let's see how do we do this one. Let's open terminal. Let's stop Tomcat. How do we stop? /shutdown.sh. So let's come out from bin. Let's go to conf directory. Okay, ls. Here you will see tomcat-users.xml file. Let's open this one. Vi rvim tomcat-user.xml. Here you will see, so tomcat users are commented. So uncomment this one. Escape I, delete this comment. So here you will see multiple users here. So there is no password for this user Tomcat. I'm creating password. So creating users, we create users in this file. That's it. So I'm creating only one user right now. This user has role Tomcat. Sorry. This user has role Tomcat. So initially I'm defining only one role. Okay. Okay. To save this file, escape shift :wq! save and quit. Okay, now come out from conf directory and enter into bin directory. Let's start tomcat dot slash startup dot sh. Okay, let's close this one. Let's restart tomcat once again. Start open web browser and start open this URL. Once again click on this manager app. Here enter tomcat and password is tomcat, right? Can you guess, is this open manager app URL, manager app? Yes, right? It will open, right? See, you will get one permission error, access denied error. So to access any manager app, we need this role. We need this role. Okay, I am copying this role. Again I am stopping tomcat. I am come out from bin directory, entering into conf directory. So let's open tomcat -users.xml file. So here it requires role call manager-GUI role. So here I am changing password is tomcat. Okay, let's save, control S, close this one. Let's come out from conf directory, enter into bin directory, start tomcat. Okay, tomcat is started. Let's again open tomcat homepage. Right, it opened. Just click on this manager app. So now it is open. Now it is opened successfully. Okay. So we given access to manager app -GUI role. When you assign this one, any user has that role, then they can open manager app. So here we will see all our deployed applications. Next we will see how to deploy var file into tomcat. We have already developed our applications, right? So how do we deploy var file? I have already downloaded or created one var file. So this is my var file location. I'll show where it is. Under downloads, I have already downloaded one var file. So this is my var file. I want to upload this var file into tomcat. So how do we upload var file means, let's open tomcat manager app. Here down you will see select var file to upload. Click on browse. Where is your var file? Under downloads, right? Open downloads. Here this is the var file. Select var file, click on open and click on deploy. When you deploy var file, it will deploy var file in web apps directory. Let's come out from bin and go to web apps directory. You will see this is the var file. It is uploaded and for this one it is created one root directory. Okay, it's still uploading. Internally it is creating required files and it is extracting var file and creating root directory, right? So it doing that process. Once it is successfully uploaded this var file, we will see that application in this list. So still it is loading. I allocated less RAM for this Linux machine, that's why it is taking time. If you allocated more RAM, then it will not take this much time. Let's down. So this is recently uploaded WAR file, right? This is my application. Let's click on this one. You will see application, right? So this is my Spring Boot web application. Okay, so I created this Spring Boot application, then converted into WAR file and deployed into where? My Tomcat directory. Whatever the way I did, you can also deploy your Tomcat, your WAR files in this Tomcat. Okay, thank you.